बाल है तेरे।
नंगा हुआ तो काहे की शर्म, माई बाप नाही ना कोई धर्म। से कड़े सादों से नरम, फन हर फन मौला हर दम।
लग जाए तेरी रगों में खून नहीं, रबड़ी दौड़ दी है रबड़ी।
रणबीर, द प्रोमोस हैव हैड अ मिक्स्ड रिएक्शन फॉर बेशरम। Do you think expectations around your films have now skyrocketed to a point where people just expect the promos to be fabulous, or do you think these promos in particular haven't worked well with the audience?
Well, it has got a mixed reaction and more towards the negative side, but that's fine. I think expectations are good. It motivates you. It shows. It puts a little bit of pressure on your work. A lot of people, you know, have problem with the songs. You know, with the kind of character I'm playing, which is a bit loud, repulsive, vulgar. You know, it's a far departure from the other characters that I played usually. So, like, I had to try this genre. You know, I had to see if I can extend myself, you know, to something which I'm not comfortable with. So, in a way, it's good that when people will come, they'll come with lesser expectations and they'll be surprised with the movie.
Mere seene mein dil nahi dost, jigar hai jigar, aur wo kabhi tootta nahi. Na aayega public, 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 public.
बेशरम दिल खोल सीना ताने बन बेशरम, गाले बन बेशरम दिल खोल सीना ताने बन बेशरम।
What are the reactions you've been getting on a one-on-one level? Like, you know, so people who've come up to you, or people you've been interacting with?
You know, the actions an actor usually gets, usually, you know, they'll say nice things only. Actor ke muh pe kyun bolenge ki
But aren't there people who give you a reality check?
Of course they are, and but they do that with every film. There are so many friends of mine who didn't like Ajab trailer, or who didn't like Barfi trailer, or didn't like Rockstar songs. But at the end, the audience is king. You can't really have preconceived notions towards a film, and you can't take reactions to trailers and songs that seriously, because when you watch a film has to work on the whole. So I take it with a pinch of salt. I take criticism as well as compliments.
You, your mom and your dad, you have said in several different interviews that you all were waiting for the right film, the right script, the right story to come along. Is Beshram that film?
Well, we thought so, you know, and we signed it, and we hope so. You know, the good part is we've not really come as a family package. We have individually liked our parts as actors, and the dynamic was spy versus spy. You know, they are corrupt cops, I'm the car thief. Constantly chasing me through the film. Whenever we meet, it's a laugh riot. So I think it was the right sensibility. We didn't go for the cliche mother, father, son drama, melodrama, conflict, you know, as usually people expect a real life father, son to enact on screen. So let's see. 2nd October, we'll know.
Haji, aap kaun?
Tera papa babua, Inspector Chulbul Chotala, aur yo teri amma, Head Constable Bulbul Chotala.
अरे खुद को तो छुड़ा ले पहले मोटे, सिर्फ चुलबुल नाम रख लेने से कोई दबंग नहीं बन जाता।
What was it like having them on set all the time, having your dad, who your mom keeps saying, you know, you can't even kind of like meet eye to eye with your father, and having him around on the set and, you know, performing important scenes with him?
Well, I think it's every kid's nightmare to work with their parents. But having said that, my parents are fabulous actors. I'm a big fan of my father's work, and he's doing such amazing work right now. It's very hard for me to express myself in real life. I'm a bit shy, so I think with this film, it kind of opened up my relationship with my father. Also, we became a little closer. We got to spend more time with each other, so it's been a good process.
That's dad. What about mom? Having mom on set, I mean, I don't think she seemed very like.
Yeah, and she's also working, you know, in a film like this after 30 years. She's dancing, you know, mouthing these dialogues, playing a very corrupt, over the top character, and she's really done it so endearingly. You know, I really believe that she's the performance of this film. And I was parenting her on set. You know, I was telling her do this, do that. You know, say this line like this. She was nervous, but it's like if you've learned how to cycle at the age of 8, even if you haven't cycled for 15 years, once you sit on it, you know, you'll find your balance.
And we're apart from, you know, your professional life, there's been so much written in the last couple of months about your personal life. Do you almost feel like it's become a bit of a zoo, it's become a bit of a circus out there?
No, yeah. You know, I believe that, you know, I've got so much from people, from the media, that I can't really sit here and complain now. You know, if they put me on a pedestal, they have all the right to put me down. They can write about my personal life. I personally don't like it. I will try and protect it as much as I can. But I have a simple philosophy. Good press or bad press, as long as they spell my name right, it's fine.
But it doesn't affect you, like, for example, when yours and Katrina's, the pictures from Ibiza, they got published in every tabloid, every news channel, every paper was carrying it. And here you are, this really private space, private moment. on national television.
You feel violated, but what can you do? You know, when I was young, if I had a favorite star, I wanted to know about him. I wanted to read about him. I wanted to know where he eats dinner, what perfume he uses, who he has dinner with. So it's only fair, you know, if people want to write about me, you know, they have all the right to. Today, paparazzi is not just the journalists and the photographers. It's even every person who has a camera phone. Today, you have social networking platforms where everyone has an opinion. So you have to be careful. At the same time, you have to take it with a pinch of salt here. Yeah. It's part of show business.
See, Ranbir, you're saying you take all these things with a pinch of salt. But Katrina didn't take it like that. She wrote an open letter to the media. Did you even know that letter was going to come out?
No, everybody has a different perspective. Maybe hers was a more honest one. And I usually have this tongue-in-cheek relationship with the media, you know, where I brush it off with some humorous line.
But it create problems at home? I mean, your parents are looking at this. And you know, there's Katrina who's looking at it. Her family is looking at all of this. Doesn't it make everything just uncomfortable?
It's show business, Janice. You know, it's all part of it. Yeah. You know, nobody has problems. My parents have no problem. I have no problem. Personally, what I feel, it doesn't matter. Because however, how much ever I cry, how much ever I say this is wrong, that is right, who am I to say it? Yeah. You know, I'm public property. Everyone's public property who works in movies. So it's okay.
You recently said in an interview that besides your parents, Ayan and Katrina are the two people you'd give up your life for. So with that,
I've also said Rohit and Aisha.
With that, but you're implying that technically she's the most important woman in your life after your mom?
Well, I also said Aisha was also a woman, by the way. But like I said, you know, I've said what I had to. If I say more things, then channels will take that and make so many articles and so many shows about it, take out layers, take out meanings, and I'm done with it, you know.
Is there someone special in your life right now? And if there is...
There are many people who are special in my life right now, and I'm single till I'm married, and the day I decide to get married, you, of course, you know, besides our working relationship, our personal friend, and I'm sure you'll be a part of my celebration and you'll be very happy for me also.
Brilliant. Okay, now I have like this whole bunch of Twitter questions for you because, you know, despite the fact that you're not on Twitter, everyone has these questions for you from Twitter. My first question comes from @RiaLoveRK. Her question is, who are the three most important people in Ranbir Kapoor's life? And Ranbir Kapoor is currently chewing on a rubber band. Let's get to the question.
Well, the three most important people right now is Abhinav Kashyap, the director of my film, because the film's releasing, and my parents who are part of the movie. These are the three most important people.
Such a diplomatic answer. At Ranbirlicious. Names are so interesting.
Sounds delicious.
Batameez Wala or Besharam Wala, which is more like him in real life? I'm Archini from Malaysia.
Which is like me? None of Ranbirlicious, I'm a little embarrassed to say that name also, is like me. I think the closest character that I've played on screen has been Wake Up Sid. Apart from that, all the other characters have been figment of my imagination and a lot of borrowed characters from the directors and the script writers.
At Eat, Pray, Love M, this is Mansi Datta. She's asking you, if you didn't come from a film family, would you still want to be an actor? Essentially, what would you be if you weren't an actor?
Hi, Mansi. I don't know. You know, maybe because subconsciously I've grown up around movies, so that has invigorated my passion and interest in acting and movies. But I don't know. I think... depends where life takes you. Yeah, I don't think I would have been anything which requires a lot of studying, because that's
so
not
no
something.
Engineer, doctor,
no engineer, doctor,
no,
and all of that. If I was an actor, maybe I would have been a struggling actor.
If you can do something Besharam right now, what would you do? Meghani from Sri Lanka.
Chal, I'll say a dialogue from Besharam too. What's
her name? Meghani from Sri Lanka.
Meghani. Meghani, lagta hai teri ragon mein khoon nahi, rabadi daudti hai rabadi.
Lagta hai teri ragon mein khoon nahi.
At Vince Media wants to know, please ask when he plans to get married.
Who's asked?
Vince Media.
Vince Media. There's no plans. I don't believe that marriage comes with age. You know, it's an organic, natural process. When it comes from inside, jab andar se jhankar bajegi, ghandiya bajegi, then I'll get married.
The next question comes from @FarzanaBegum2. Ask him when we are going to see him and Sonam together again in a movie. There's also another question where someone else is asking you, when are you working with Alia?
Okay, first question is
Sonam.
And who has asked this?
Farzana Begum.
Hi, Farzana. Sonam has been my first co-star. We've started, our career in movies together, but unfortunately, no one has offered us a film together. But hopefully, you know, one day somebody will cast us together and we'll work again. About Alia, again, nobody's offered me a film. I'm a big fan of her work. I had the good fortune of seeing Imtiaz's unreleased film, Highway, and I really thought that she was one of the best performances by a female lead I've ever seen on screen.
At Megha Jain 295 wants to know, what kind of role are you playing in Jagga Jasoos? Also give lots of my love to him.
Hi, Megha. Thank you for the love, and I send it right back to you. The role I play is of a detective. he's a school boy. He studies in the 12th standard, and he's that's the role.
Cool
in Jagga Joseph. I'm a 12th standard boy, and it's going to be a fun detective film with a lot of mystery, a lot of songs. It's a musical, a lot of romance, and a little bit of thrills and action.
At Ranbir for Life is asking, you're going to be 31 soon.
Thanks again.
Is there any Besharmi planned on that day?
Who said this?
His name is Bun Besharam. We don't know his real
name. Bun Besharam, nice name. No, I hate my birthdays. I think it's very overrated and nobody really makes me feel special anymore because people think that I'm earning money now, so nobody buys me gifts. And birthdays are meant to be gifts. Yeah, but still, you want free gifts are always fun.
Okay.
You know, where you don't spend from your own pocket. So I usually go for dinner with my parents at home at night. My friends come, they wish me happy birthday.
And throw one big party for you.
No party. I hate parties. Once the Rockstar team threw a party for me and I was hugely embarrassed. But this year, thankfully, it'll be a quiet birthday.
Right. Thank you so much, Ranbir.
Cheers, bro.
हमारे धंधे में गलती की सिर्फ एक सजा होती है
मौत
मुझे क्या पता नहीं है